Hey y'all, what's up? Welcome back to the garage. And today we're gonna be putting on the Wings exhaust. So prior to doing that, we've got to take off the Perun Moto luggage rack here. So that's these two screws and these two screws here, respectively. We got to take the seat off. We got to take this panel off here, and this panel here too, of course, and then pop this bad boy off. So it's not too complicated. What comes with the Wings exhaust? You get the pipe adapter. Actually, you get the exhaust with it, of course. The exhaust comes with two baffles, and they call them DB killers. So this is the smaller one, which is the quieter of the two, I'm assuming, and the larger one is there. And for comparison, you can turn it this way. I think you can kind of tell that the one that's in there is slightly bigger in diameter. So it's got the carbon fiber tip. I got the carbon fiber heat shield. You could have elected to keep the stock one, which is that, and I think that, I don't know if they have a brushed aluminum one as well. I think they just ask if you want to keep the stock one or go with this. So I thought I'd go with this and check it out and see what it looks like. If it doesn't look that good, I can always put the other one back on. So there's that. Here is the clamp that will hold the exhaust pipe in place. Screw for it. Here is some lube that goes on the rubber part of the bracket so that it doesn't dent the pipe when you put it in. And that's it. They give you a nice little set of instructions if you can't figure out how to do it, but there are plenty of other YouTube videos that show how to do it. They also give you some stickers and a nice t-shirt, so that's kind of cool. So initially, to get the Perun plate off, we need an H5 hex wrench, and after that we're going to need the T30 Torx to get off what's underneath this. So first, let me set this here. Hopefully that's a decent view. So pop this guy off. And these are the Torx screws that's got to come out. Really, it's only this one. Which, surprisingly, it was good that I came to do this, because this was actually coming loose already. This one is too, so I got to torque them back down upon completion. So anyway, that's it. Not really too hardcore. And again, we're just taking out those four screws, and then this whole rack comes off. As you can see, that's the only point of attachment. These things here are just spacers that sit there. And for stuff like this, if you got aftermarket stuff that you've put on, take a picture of it or something, right? So here you can see there's different size spacers. So I know where they go, but just heads up, take a picture if you think you'll forget, and get yourself something like this to keep your screws and stuff in. It's a real time saver. And for this here, really the those spacers are only used if you use the hand holds, which I do use, so. Just show you know. So again, like I say, take a picture if you don't remember which spacer was where, and is also the orientation of the handholds. So now that those are out, this whole thing just comes off. And here's what the other side looks like. So really the Perun luggage rack is actually this smaller plate here. This top piece, here is the luggage rack extension. But you can see how it all goes together. It's pretty slick. And this is just the KTM stock luggage bag. I don't think they've got any name for it other than that. So now you can see the four larger spacers. You just sit in there. And like I say, I'm kind of anal about trying to keep my stuff situated because I will forget how they went back together because I don't take this apart every day. If your bike did not come with the passenger grips on here, which would go here and here, obviously, and you can see the passenger pads here. You will not have these holes drilled out, so that doesn't matter for you in this case. It doesn't matter at all. It only matters when, say that you didn't have the hand holds and you wanted to get the luggage rack and put it on. So in any event, you still got to drill this out. And in the service manual, there's the specs as far as the on center for the holes and all that stuff. So. Anyway, I got mine with the passenger handle, so I didn't have to muck with that. So now, this, like I say, this was already loose, so this is actually a blessing that I chose to do this because I have never checked these before. In terms of checking the tightness, right? The other one is right here, okay? So that's screw number two that comes out, and then this Phillips head, and it looks like, okay, I was gonna say it looks like this is loose, but it's not. It's meant to be spaced out like that because that's where the plastic piece clips into it. Size Phillips head, so let's see what we got here. Maybe a little bit. Let's try this one. Yep, perfect. Of definitely want to see six more. This, he spins with it. So we'll just put him with screw that attaches him, like so, and then keep that down. And a little quartz tray. These trays are great, man. Matrix Concepts, I really like this one. There's a bunch of others. And even like if you've got a stool like this, right, it comes with a little thing, just something where you can keep those screws and miscellaneous pieces, because it sucks having to look for them later. Alright. Ooh, just right. Okay, so this screw here is a T40. And let's look and see what this Jimmy Joe is. Let's see, it might be the T30. Let's check. So let's go ahead and loosen him up. Okay, so we'll just use PCS loose enough, right, just to slide off. So now, let's get this big boy. Just a little bit. There we go. Get him out. Set him down there. Drop this down. Just kind of. Let's loosen him up some more. I may actually have to take that all the way off. Let's find out. Talking about this. There we go. That was not the most graceful thing in the world, but it worked. Anyway, the orientation of this was this way. This is the pipe adapter. Notice it's got a handy up signal there, so it's going to go on basically like this. Which, let's see if I can try to do. I know, got a beautiful workbench and like 40 inches of real estate here to work with. Floppy house. I'm literally going to spread it with my fingers, praying that this is not acidic and it eats the skin off, but given that it's going on rubber, I don't think that's the case. And the paper says that this stuff will, from where it slides around on the pipe, that it'll burn off anyway, so if you're worried about getting a little bit on the pipe, don't be. Here's the screw that comes with it. Jenny, hang on, baby. Okay, so this screw is a H6. And the orientation that this goes on is going to be, this goes to the back. So you gotta finagle it a little bit. But anyway, it's on there loosely. And actually, let me get a couple more cranks just to make sure it's didn't blow off on us. So now, you just need to make sure you tighten this guy up. This is, that slid all the way on. And then of course, this will just kind of find its place. The gist of the oil is that they say that it's better for this to slide around because if it grips off position and you tighten it up, you literally dent this up. So hence the reason for the oil. Tighten this guy up first. When I say this guy, I'm referring to this. Good. Frank told me that's Aussie tight, which is just good and snug. He didn't strip it out, but also I didn't bust out the torque wrench. So that's pretty much it, man. Pop the side plates on and start this bad dog up. Okay, so let's go ahead and get this thing buttoned back up. So the first thing we'll do is put this plate here back on. The other plate, the Perun rack, we could actually do the Perun rack after the seat, but it doesn't matter. We just flow with it. So I'm going to set that like there. That should be a better view, hopefully. I'm going to find out when I edit this crap. Okay, so let's go ahead and get this thing later on, I'll redo those and put some rock right on it. So this is where the other T11 is.
me quedará la voz suave del mar. Volver a respirar la lluvia que caerá sobre este cuerpo y mojará la flor que crece en mí. Y volver a reír y cada día un instante volver a pensar en ti y en la voz suave.
Plate that just snaps on here. A couple other places it snaps on as well. Back on. Before this, we first got to put our long spacers back in. I will muck with this offline. Okay, so there you have it. There's the finished product. I'm having second thoughts about putting that carbon fiber heat shield on, so I'm going to percolate on that for a little bit. But anyway, that's the finished product.